Esther Trufan, and in this video, I'm going to demonstrate how the addition of sodium chloride can impact the freezing point of water or the melting point of ice. So for this experiment, we're going to need some sodium chloride, some deionized water, and some ice. And then, because I want to make sure that I'm measuring the appropriate amounts, I'm going to bring in an extra beaker and a pipette. Because we're going to perform three measurements at once, we're going to use three approximately 150 milliliter beakers. We will need to know the mass of the sodium chloride that we're adding. We're going to need a scale and a weighing boat. And because we are going to monitor temperature changes, we're going to need a thermometer. For this experiment, because the temperature is likely to go below minus 10 degrees Celsius, it is important that we select a suitable thermometer that is able to determine the temperature, even if that is below minus 10 degrees, which is the limit of most Celsius thermometers. So for this experiment, I will be using a thermometer that measures the temperature in Fahrenheit. All the temperatures that I will be calling out today will be in degrees Fahrenheit. And this thermometer measures the temperature all the way down to minus 40 degrees Fahrenheit. Let's begin our measurements. In each of these beakers, I will add 10 grams of deionized water. And for these measurements, I want to be as close to the value as I possibly can. After I place my first beaker on the scale, I will tear it, and then I will add as close as possible to 10 grams of deionized water. And if I become a little bit uncertain, I can always transition to the use of a pipette. And in my first beaker, I have exactly 10.00 grams of water. Now I place my second beaker on the scale, tear it, and measure out another 10 grams of water. When I get close, I transition to the use of the pipette. And I measured out another exactly 10.00 grams of water. I will do the same thing for my third beaker. I will tear it first. Then I will pour the water. If it is more than 10 grams, I can extract it. And I can transfer it into a waste container. And with that, I have all three of my 10 grams of water in each of these beakers. Next, I'm going to place my weighing boat on the scale, tear it, and then first measure out 5 grams of sodium chloride. I have just a little bit more. It is 5.07 grams. At this point, I can make a decision whether to remove the excess or leave it on and keep track of it. I will remove mine. And now I have exactly 5.00 grams of sodium chloride. I will add this to my first beaker. For my second beaker, I will measure out 7.5 grams of sodium chloride. That seems reasonable. It is 7.51 grams. I will add this to my second beaker. Into my final beaker, I will add 10 grams of my sodium chloride. And I measured out exactly 10.00 grams of sodium chloride. I will transfer all of this into my third beaker. And with that, I am done with my mass measurements for now. I will swirl my mixtures until as much of the sodium chloride as possible dissolves. And then we get ready for our final step. That is the addition of ice. We're going to add to each of these beakers 40 grams of ice. And after we add it, we're going to mix it around a little bit and then wait until the temperature is the same for approximately a minute and a half to at least 2 minutes. I will demonstrate how to perform this part of the experiment on the first solution, and then you may perform the remainder of the measurements on the additional two beakers exactly the same way. So as we move to the next step, we're going to turn on our scale, place an empty beaker on top, tear it, and then we're going to add 40 grams of ice. And we want to be as close as we can be to the 40 grams. It is exactly 40.00 grams of ice. We set the scale to the side, we bring in our beaker, and then we transfer all the ice inside the beaker very carefully so that the ice does not fly all over the place and it needs to be contained. And with that, most of our transfer is complete. If there is any remaining ice sticking to the beaker, we should try to move it along as efficiently as possible. And with that, all my ice is fully transferred and I am ready to perform my measurement. Now that we mix our ice with our salt water solution, let's move on and monitor the temperature. And we can already feel that it's really, really cold. So we take our thermometer and we're going to slide it into the beaker and we'll swirl our mixture around to make sure that all our salt is dissolved. And we can see how our temperature is plummeting. It is now around 30 degrees. And remember, these are Fahrenheit degrees. All our salt is fully dissolved in the water, but we know that the water that is a solid in the form of ice isn't actually participating in the solution. So the concentration of the sodium chloride is only determined by the mass of the sodium chloride that we added and the mass of the water that became a liquid. So we want to make sure that there is a good balance between the concentration of the sodium chloride that we anticipate and the associated temperature depression. When more than half of your ice is melted, then that may be a good time to begin the recording of the temperature in earnest and monitor for any changes that occur from there on. And for about a minute and a half, it has been reading 21.0 degrees Fahrenheit. This is a good cue for me to end the experiment and move on to my second beaker, to which I will add the ice and monitor associated temperature changes.